everything go to everyone. Today, we are going to start family reproductive system modeling competition. The objective of today's study lecture is we should be able to understand the function of anatomy and the organization of family reproductive system. Second, we should be able to describe in brief the events of menstrual cycle in every human being. Three, explain the capability to explain the hormonal regulation of endometrial and ovarian cycle. Four, we should be able to understand the events of fertilization and infertility. In fact, we can avoid the extreme the placental physiology and placental health. And we can avoid the extreme the neuroendocrine reflexes related to this disease. So we should cover this factor in the following segments. First, functional anatomy, a human process system. Second, we should cover the functions of puberty, growth, health, menstrual cycle, which will be an irrelevant issue for the day, as ovarian cycle and endometrial cycle. Then, fertilization and implantation. Next, will be the secondary situation, where we can understand about the labor and menstruation is actually implanted. Human reproductive system are composed of ovaries and accessory organs. Which includes fallopian tube, uterus, cervix, the vagina, and external genitals. This is covered in the following heading as sexual anatomy. Sexual anatomy consists of the nerves, in ovaries, and accessory organs, which includes the vagina, fallopian tube, uterus, cervix, the vagina, and external genitals. Cervix starts with the ovary is located into the peritoneal fold of the ovary, and this internal fold is called the growth plate. The ovary consists of outer cortex and inner membrane. The cortex consists of cellular skin and ovarian membrane. The fallopian contains the egg, known as the primary receptor. It is surrounded by follicular cells. The cortex is covered by connective tissue layer called tunica albuginea and ovarian surface epithelial layer. The medulla contains neurovascular lumen. So, there are nanoducts or tracts in ovary to connect the ovary and the reproductive organs, which is tubes, for transporting ovaries. So, ovaries are the peritoneal organ, and when the ovaries and cells are released from the ovary, the cells briefly recharge within the peritoneal cavity before they are collected by the singular fallopian tube. So, ovaries are peritoneal organ, and the ovulated egg briefly recharges in the peritoneal cavity before they are collected by the singular fallopian tube. The fallopian tube. The fallopian tube provides tracts for transport of ovaries from ovary to uterus. The distal end of fallopian tube called perimethylium, which forms in multiple finger-like projections from finger-like. The perimethylium is lined by simulated epithelium cells, which leads towards voltage. The beating of cilia and the contraction of the wall of fallopian tube facilitates the ovarian construction. Next, uterus. Uterus is a pleural muscular organ suspended by fallopian ligament in the peritoneal cavity. It consists of chamber, tympan, and cervix. The external surface is covered by cerebellum, and the internal surface is called endometrium. that ending of poetry answers us frankly grumbling at history and sin. The middle of poetry says this, which is something new as the world. Let's close it. Tell it that little the world turns out Latin lyrics, Latin lyrics, Latin lyrics, is the more and narrow portion of Scripture where it joins with the Hosanna at an angle of 90 degrees. Next, the Hosanna is a 10 centimeter long tube like structure and joined by 45 epithelium. Next, the external genital ring, which includes clitoris, labia nova, labia minora. The clitoris is made up of pelvic fins. And the adult fruit skeleton diagram is pubertal. Pubertal is the transition between juvenile stage and muscular adult stage. Then, hypothalamus pituitary juvenile axis become activated. The endocrine and the reproductive function of the males become muscular. And the individual female develops the ability to procreate. During this puberty, secondary sexual characteristics develop and adolescent growth starts active. The age of onset of puberty in female is between 8 to 13 years. The secondary sexual characteristics is active during this puberty in male. Namely, development of this, which is called clarity, appearance of pubic and axillary hair, beginning of menstruation, menarche, which is also called menarche, growth spot, and single pattern growth spot, and the scanty body hair, and characteristics for single hair, and also characteristic distribution of adipose tissue in the body. Menstruation. What is it? The menstrual cycle in the human reproductive system follows characteristic cyclical changes throughout the reproductive period. The cyclical events are required for preparation for fertilization and conception, followed by shedding of uterine epithelium as bleeding and menstruation. The human female menstrual cycle are mainly 28 days plus or minus 4 days. The cyclical changes are mainly seen in early and late years. The cyclical change occurs in the early is called ovarian cycle. The ovarian cycle are the functional unit of the ovary. Ovaries are found in the fetal life within the paramental cycle of ovary. There are 7 million paramental cycles of fetal life of female, which drops down to only 2 million due to atrophy at the time of birth. The life history of follicle in a single menstrual cycle can be divided into 2 main stages. One is follicular stage, which is also called follicular genesis, and second is the luteal phase, which is commonly due to compressed luteus. Next, the follicular stage. Follicular stage can be divided into following stages. First, paramarital cycle. Paramarital cycle appears into the mid gestation period, into the fetal life. This follicle contains embryo or egg. This embryo enter the process of meiosis and become paramarital. Paramarital becomes surrounded by clinical epithelium of follicle cells and it is called paramarital cycle. These ovarian follicles are total ovarian rhizomes. The total rhizome of follicles in the center of fetal life is around 7 million. The number continues to be declined to 3 million paramarital follicles at the time of sexual maturity at puberty. Unlike adults, 450 paramarital follicles exist during total reproductive period. From the last 2 months. Bibbia è accaduto il cammino di Bibbia. E a cambiare il tempo di Bibbia è un po' in nostra nota di vita. E di fare cambiare. Bene, dove adesso, dove la fare di vita adesso, in modo di tutto, che tu è un po' di vita. Questo è interessante. Da Felicia, Grace, di Grace, a Fiorenza, chi vede la vita che è un'altra famiglia. A chi vede, chi vede la famiglia, ma da Felicia, la famiglia, che è un'altra famiglia, che è un'altra famiglia, che è un'altra famiglia. Questo è il secondo momento. Questo è il secondo momento. Indeed, the great work in our story, indeed, people from there and the church. This stage is needed. This stage is found as natural theological intelligence. This is important. Several great and astounding stage appearance as a field field stage between the Anglican Church and the British Church in the it suffers the Romanical Church layer into two layers, the outer cell layer is called neural dermatical and the inner cell, inner layer is called inner cell layer, as we try to learn two layers of cell. And this two layer cell contains two cells. Next, dominant cell. At the end of the central period, a group of large central cells are recruited for rapid growth under the influence of typical dermatocytes. But only the largest cell of the recruited group remains viable, and these two cells dominant cells. The other cells of the recruited group undergo atrophy. The next phase is regulation, where it is defined as expulsion of these similar cell cells out of the body, which contains the dominant cell, that is, it contains the dominant cell. It occurs at day 15 of a normal menstrual cycle. Just before the process of regulation, there is increased mobility at the human level, which is the lowest stage. Produces structural changes in the dominant cell, which includes the access and the control expulsion of the similar cell complex out of the body and formation of proper tissue. Any stage is necessary for final follicular growth and ovulation. Around 48 hours before ovulation, early standing situation increases from 90 to 90. It achieves the peak 15 days before ovulation by raising 6 to 10 fold of its level. A typical final level also rose just before the next luteal phase. At the end of ovulation, the remaining part of its dominant cell is called the luteal, which contains mineral barrier factors and the cytosis. The type of lutein is progressed to be degenerated after 13 years. This type of lutein is called type of lutein mutation. The degeneration can be rescued by the human genomic developmental gene, which is mainly supported from the implanted embryo in the type of lutein. The rescued type of lutein is called type of lutein formation, which remains viable throughout the process. Next is the event of the secondary endometrium during the same cycle, is endometriosis. This cycle includes the complicated changes of ovarian cycle and associated with the creation of ovarian sclerosis. Ovarian endometrium cells mainly three different stages during the menstrual cycle. First is follicular phase. In this phase, it starts with the end of the menstrual cycle, and the superficial layer of the endometrium is sclerotic. is invented that regular reviews of demonstrations. So, I mean, I'm going to this one that we regulate these demonstrations during the menstrual phase that is present in progesterone level and very low. Because of the degeneration of complex tissue. Due to increase of the medical similar changes overall hormones to associated areas into the anterior pituitary, we are going to be able to reach the deficit 20 increase. Into the inner primary follicular phase, the balance in the deficit level increases and reaches the large inner follicle for rapid deficit dependent growth. This repeated follicle produces low level of estrogen and inhibit DNA. In response to this rise of estrogen, deficit level again can be reduced in the metabolic index. In ovary, the decreased deficit level leads to follicular atrophy. The follicular growth will be affected along with self-estrogen. Except one follicle is established as abdominal cell. The largest follicle with most number of deficits is at 10 centimeters, which means low level of deficits, and can establish as the abdominal cell. Now, this dominant follicle produces fat follicles producing a very high amount of estrogen, which produces a positive feedback effect on pituitary gland that can lead to a mid-cycle allergic response. This allergic response is essential for ovulation. Now, after ovulation, practice meeting the nut and seeking the source of progesterone and ovarian and produces again a negative feedback on the mother. And after 13 days, proper sleeping develops and the ovarian hormone level becomes decreased. So this is how the level of menstrual cycle is regulated. Next, this is not an indicator of ovulation. So what the indicator first is symptomatic phenomenon, that is that cervical mucus can be stretched out into folds about 10 to 12 centimeters due to elastic property in presence of high estrogen. Next is the fine pattern, fine like pattern of cervical mucus and growing over estrogen indicates that teen ovulation. Next, basal body temperature, just after ovulation, progesterone increases, or even basal body temperature is an position in this form, basal body temperature is an emerging indicator of ovulation. Next, human amount of blood is spreading into the peritoneal cavity at the time of ovulation, causing pain and discomfort. It is also an indicator. So, in this indicator, we can externally, we can show that ovulation and we can detect the condition. Next, fertilization of intentions. Now, fertilization is the process where recombination of male and female genetic material forms a genetically distinct female. Fertilization takes place at the angula fallopian tube. After ejaculation, male sperm travel through the vagina, uterus, and reach until the angula of fallopian tube. And after ejaculation, ovum is collected by the singular end of fallopian tube and reached into the antenna. So, fertilization. Fertilization typically occurs at day 16 or 17 of the menstrual cycle. Implementation after fertilization occurs about 6 days after ovulation, means at day 22. The fertilized ovum is then transported through the fallopian tube within the uterus for implantation. The action of CAD epithelium or CAD beating that lines the fallopian tube assists the sperm movement towards the movement of the fertilized ovum towards the uterus. At day 2 after implantation, the embryo reaches the 16th cell medulla oblongata, the nerve of the testis medulla. by birthday and birthday, these people do not choose to change. But their choices is to engage the schools and population of Paris to get them by the school to use the living. That will not change. And that they can get this. And the final conclusion, the total block will be sensitive and be two types of soil, the inner and purpose block here, and the outer change the purpose of block here. The physical purpose of block here to the whole nutrition to the environment, that will be the result of silver layer, and the physical purpose of block here, the plant and justice function and proper implementation and the endocrine function from environment is produced. We should know something about the symptoms. That is, the positive system and the surrounding endothelium layer forms the symptoms. The symptoms perform several functions for membranes of cells. So, what are the symptoms? First, it prevents the entry of toxic material and prevents some metabolic drain to cells. Second, it provides nutrition and oxygen to its tissues and removes formula from tissues and also certain waste products from the tissues. The major nutrients is transported from the blood to tissues and glucose, mainly by facilitated nutrition, and the medicine, mainly by secondary active transport, vitamins, minerals, vitamins, antibodies, only IgG type of antibodies, and lipoproteins. The waste products are mainly urea and creatinine, and possibly constituted 3% of classical symptoms. Next, we should know about placental hormones. The first problem is human chromatin gonadotropin, or called HCG. The first hormone produced by the synthetic blood cell is HCG. The primary action of HCG is to prevent nucleolysis of corpus luteum, that's regeneration of corpus luteum, and maintain it, you can maintain it during the pregnancy. Now, this HCG is also associated with muscular body sickness and inflammation. Presence of HCG in urine is used as a pregnancy detection because it is less than maintained during the placental production. Placenta produces high amount of progesterone, which is essential to maintain pregnancy. Placental production is important for breast development, estrogen level, and milk production. Placental progesterone is the source of fetal cortisol hormones. This hormone is placental estrogen. Placental estrogen stimulates the growth of internal muscle units and is essential during vasculation or during birth. It induces muscle development, mainly ductile contraction and advancing of the immune system. Next hormone is human chorionic somatotropin. It is also called HCS. It is also called placental estrogen. HCS has a sexual similarity to growth hormone and somatotropin. It is also called fetal growth hormone as it induces fetal as well as placental growth chromatin. HCS carries protein anabolic, electrolytic, and anti-insulin effects. We also know about gametogenesis and nutrition. Gametogenesis is composed of around 20 modules and exclusively is two plus bits. Each layer is divided into several alveoli, which are lined by narrow epithelial cells. Breast development is facilitated during pregnancy with extensive ductal growth, dancing, lovely alveolar placental estrogen, progesterone, and the placental estrogen stimulates this breast development. Lactogenesis is known as milk production Thank you.